the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The flow. Ingagos. Jesus revealed His teaching in the Gospel as the greatest and the first commandment, to love God. But He did not start there. He immediately added a second commandment, to love your neighbor as yourself. It is like the first. The phrase and the second is like it highlights this emphasis on the similarity between the two commandments rather than their differences. This underscores the importance of loving God, our neighbor, even ourselves, interconnected and almost equally significant as a flow. Mamagus, ing lugod king Diyos, king aparang tao, at king sarili. We know and we believe in the wisdom of the Gospel, but we are also called to act on it by working for inclusion and focusing of whatever unites us. You cannot say, I love God, but I hate my neighbor, especially those who are not the same like us. O detang etamong kaugali, etamong kaisip, etamong kalupa, puringgawan. Loving our neighbors are more difficult, who are more difficult and even opposed to us, can be challenging because of the prevalent notion of othering. They are others. Iba sila. Iba tayo. However, Jesus calls us to love, to accept, to respect, and even appreciate our differences, just as we proclaim our love for God. Jesus is very consistent. Even to love your enemies. Hindi lang po yung kabaro natin, kaibigan natin o kaisip natin. We can consciously overcome exclusivity or discrimination by focusing on our similarities and fostering an inclusive culture. Our faith and love for God challenge us to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Othering. Iba yan. Iba tayo. Today, there's a strong emphasis on differences. Social marketing and advertising often promotes the idea that purchasing a product will set us apart. Iba tayo eh. Making us different and even superior to others. Politics and religion can also contribute to the othering by highlighting our differences rather than our similarities. Mayroon kaming professor, ang pangalan niya Pastor Nathaniel Canlas. Pastor siya, pero professor namin sa Protestantism. Mayroon kaming subject sa theology, Protestantism. We studied the teachings of the Protestants. Pero sabi ng aming professor na Protestante, na pastor, sabi ni Professor Protestant Pastor Nathaniel Canlas, huwag muna natin pag-usapan yung pagkaiba natin. Pag-usapan natin ano yung pagkapareho natin. Let us not talk about our differences. Let us talk about what our shared beliefs and faith. The second is like it. It's not different. We are the same. Definition of the other emphasizes on our distinction, creating subtle division that can lead to marginalization and discrimination. They are pagans, they are Gentiles, they are Samaritans, they are women, they are children, they are unbelievers, they are atheists, iba sila. Even in our modern times beyond Jesus, there are many sad stories of hatred, violence, crime resulting from discrimination. Sa ibang bansa, pag iba yung kulay mo, iba yung tingin sa'yo. Ibang lahi mo, iba yung tingin sa'yo. Tayo baliktad, pag ibang lahi, kagad parang matas ang tingin natin sa kanila. We welcome them easily. We respect them. Pag may bisita tayong nagsisimbang hindi natin kalahi, parang we already give them that positive acceptance and welcome. Salamat sa attitude ng mga Pinoy. But many people are bullied and shamed by those considered unacceptable and different. This can be traumatic and difficult to those who are discriminated against. The second is like it. It's not different. We are the same. This is the voice of Jesus expressing his deep longing and prayer in John. John 17:21. I pray that they may always be one, just as you are one, our Father, in me and I in you. Hindi na sila iba. Our love for God is our first commandment, and our love for our neighbor is our second commandment, intertwined just as we are naturally loving one another. They are alike. Love for God, love for neighbor, and love for self. Hindi naman pwedeng mahal mo ang Diyos tapos pinapabayaan mo sarili mo. Hindi naman pwedeng mahal mo yung pamilya mo tapos ikaw pinapabayaan mo sarili mo. There's nothing wrong when you learn how to love yourself in a positive way. Sabi nga ni Jesus, love others as you love yourself. Mahalin mo yung iba kung paano ang pagmamahal mo sa sarili mo. Huwag mong pabayaan ang sarili mo. Because it is also your responsibility to take care of the life the Lord has given you. Minsan may social experiment. May mga bata, pinagsama-sama sila. Bagong silang ng mga bata, babies, iba-iba silang kulay. May puti, may brown, may black, may yellow. Iba yung, in short, iba-ibang lahi. Nung naglalaro sila, they did not even notice that they are different. Our biases, tayong matatanda, tayo ang naglalagay ng kulay sa kulay natin. Nakukulayan ang pagtingin natin sa kulay natin, sa itsura natin. But when we were young, we did not have that bias. Differences in nationality, ethnicity, and even gender, children does not have that. They enjoyed each other's company, accepting each other as friends and companions, and even playmates as they were playing together. Out of the love of God for us, He allowed His own Son to become like us human. See, ang Diyos nga naging isa kasama natin. He humbled Himself in the same and likeness of men. Kaya nga kailangan inclusion, not exclusion. Manabi, manabi. Belongingness and building relationships. Sabi nga nila, pag Kristiyano ka, ang modelo ng iyong buhay ay lamesa. Tingnan mo yung lamesa. Tingnan mo yung lamesa. The Eucharistic table. Walang pader. Walang susi. Walang pintuan. It's an open-ended. Open. Everything's there. And it is welcome for everybody to share. Ang ugali daw natin dapat lamesa, hindi lansena. Alam niyo po yung lansena? Nakasara. Naka-display. Nakatago. Kumisan mayroong panglock. Nung bata pa po kami, alam niyo naman po, sorry sa mga matatanda, mayroong tita yung papa ko sa mga bebe. Mayroon silang lansena. Alam niyo po, nung bata kami, baka kayo rin, kayo kasi lumaki kayo sa tabi ng American base. Pero kami na taga Florida at saka Makabebe, hindi masyado. Pero sa Makabebe, maraming mga taga US of Hay. Mga kamag-anak na lang galing sa Amerika, 70s. Kaya lang nung 70s, hindi pa tayo nakakabili ng corn beef, di ba? Spam, ham, yung mga imported na kape. Ngayon, available na yan dyan, di ba? O free market na. Pero nung unang panahon, nakalansena yung mga pagkain, di ba? Nakalak. Nung bata kami, tinitingnan namin yung pinadalang imported goods dun sa tita lola namin. Sabi nung pinsan ko, tignan nyo, wow, corn beef. Wow, spam. Wow, ham, yung nakalatang ham. Sabi nung isang kamag-anak namin, for your eyes only. Hanggang tinitingnan mo lang parang museum, no? Ang buhay natin hindi lansena. Ang buhay natin lamesa. Open to love everyone, to be inclusive, not exclusive. Realizing that the love of God and neighbor involves primarily focusing on what we share in common that the most fundamental anchor that connects all of us. Marami tayong pagkakaiba. Ugali pa lang, hindi na tayo pareho. Kumisan nga yung ugali na hindi tayo pareho nakakapanasakit. Pero kailangan natin tanggapin. This is our reality. Yung ang magkakapatid, pare-pareho na yung apelido, pare-pareho na yung pinanggalingan, pare-pareho yung kinain nila, bata sila, pag lumaki na sila, hindi pa rin pare-pareho yung buhay nila, even yung ugali nila. This emphasis on goodwill among us creates relationships and fosters a positive atmosphere of cooperation between and different groups. Our efforts to improve our ecology, our shared concern for the environment, our call to unite us in assisting the advantage among us, those who want to work for peace and truth, just as the physically disabled, the elderly, the poorest of the poor, highlights the importance of Christian leadership. It leads us to a hub of cooperation where we can practically work together rather than emphasizing our differences. Loving our neighbor is akin to loving our God. Life is like water. It flows from the beginning until the end. Water flows in one direction. Nakakita na ba kayo ilog na una kahapon? Yung dating ng tubig, the flow of the water is going here. Yung agos ng tubig papunta dito. Pero kinabukasan yung agos ng tubig pag ganun. Hindi pwede yun, di ba? The direction of the water is always pointing in the same direction. Dito sa Sapang Bato, meron tayong sapa. Yata. Or dati, may sapa tayo. Pero yung dating ng tubig, pare-pareho lang. It's a connection. Water flows in one direction. It is like our Christian mission and purpose. Water is cleansing and purifying, like our love, which gives life and sustains it, which flows through God and ourselves and our neighbors. Both water and love flow from their source and return to God, their ultimate origin and beginning. May God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.